Hi, my name is Bart.
And I'm a part of the SAAC team. Last year, we made it our mission to develop programming that supported young adults with autism. Young adults with autism face a host of challenges after leaving high school. They are less likely to continue their education, they face high rates of unemployment, and they have limited access to quality programming. To get started, we found amazing organizations that believed in our vision. The first thing we did was we got Andrea McCormick, a board-certified behavior analyst, to help us with our programming. The intention was to create a fun and engaging learning experience for young adults as well as adults living with an autism spectrum diagnosis. We try to take any skills learned within a classroom setting or within a one-to-one setting and apply them within a real-life setting. After developing the curriculum, we then found some amazing students to support. Throughout the year, we worked with our students on a variety of different areas, from daily living skills such as laundry and cooking, to learning about technology that makes communication easier. We also made time to have some fun, from our daily yoga and fitness sessions to exciting field trips to the Ripley's Aquarium and the Ontario Science Centre. One of the best parts of this program is helping our students learn through real-world experiences. For example, we introduced the SAAC Cafe, where students were given the opportunity to practice food serving, order taking, and payment processing skills. These cafe experiences were such a hit that we created a one-day event called the SAAC Holiday Market. The entire event was led by our living and learning students, from setup to cleanup to making and selling delicious food. This special event gave our students a platform to showcase their skills to the public. The Living and Learning program has had a big impact on the students and families we serve.
The changes we have seen in Omar are many. In fact, we are starting to see some of what he's learned with the Living and Learning program at home. He's using a lot of polite manners. For instance, the other day he said to me, thank you very much for giving me my chips, or you're very welcome. And these are some things that he has never spontaneously said to us before. And a lot of that is coming from what the training of the dedicated staff that have been working with Omar at the Living and Learning program. He is also able to sustain longer conversations with us, and we are happy, really happy to see that. And he just has a very positive demeanor.
We're extremely grateful for your partnership, and from everyone here at SAAC, we just want to say,
thank you!